Over here.
Cable. I said the cable. Now move it. So, the rest of us can cross here. Bing. Back by the bridge. Set up diversionary fire. Minute from now. Go. Bernstein, you're first up. Do it. Nunzio, you're next.
I don't think so, Pierce.
Move it. Now. Pierce, ow!
Somebody's stuck on the cable.
Help me. I'm gonna go down there.
Help!
All games are hereby terminated. All players near the cable crossing, prepare to lend assistance as necessary. All games are hereby terminated.
Hold on, son. Hold on. Now, there's my plane.
Help! Hold on! I can't! Bullshit! Can't! Help!
Hang on, you're in jail.
Grip me! Grip. Grip. Yeah, he's got him!
Hold it!
Hang on, you're in jail. Hang on.
Hold on!
Okay, now easy, easy.
Hang on.
You've got to just ease it. Good job, Michael.
Good job.
You're okay, man. Get him up to headquarters.
Messed up. Pretty bad.
Might have been worse. Come on, let's go.
Hey, nice work. All right.
Michael.
What are we doing this weekend?
Working here or what else?
No. That was last weekend.
Sugar Bear, don't get started.
Michael, I'm getting tired of seeing your face around here. I'd like to see you in college.
Yeah. And so would my mom. Yeah, I know.
I want to ask you something.
Why do you continue to hang around with an old retired grunt like me? I can't even pay you a decent wage.
Sugar Bear.
I'll tell you why. Because you're good at playing war games. You got a good talent for it. Everything you do here smiles back at you. You need to get serious, get off your butt, give it a chance, and go back to school.
Hey, Sugar Bear, give me a little space, all right?
Former State University professor David Forrest, better known as Dr. Dave, creator of the famous hallucinogen Forrest Fire, is being released from federal penitentiary today.
I feel depressed, I feel so bad.
At an interview prior to his release today, Dr. Forrest was asked...
Are you okay?
I'm fine.
Why didn't you watch where you were going?
Me? You ran the stop sign.
Look, the point is you were speeding.
No, the point is you ran the stop sign and you're gonna pay for it.
I don't have time for this. Here.
Oh, great. A matchbook.
Yeah, it's where I work. Call me later.
Is there a name that goes with this?
CJ.
What's that stand for?
It's none of your business.
You need some help?
No, thank you.
Six Action News reporting to you live at the release of Dr. Dave Forrest, who was catapulted into international fame as his homemade hallucinogen, Forrest Fire, became the fuel of a generation of love children. Dr. Dave is being released today from maximum security Soledad State Prison. You may remember him back in the 60s. I was just a young kid of 16 at that time. He was convicted. The kids referred to
him as Dave.
Thank you very much, Lord.
Okay. What are you going to do with your freedom?
Freedom? I'm going to see if it exists.
Dr. Dave, money.
They only gave me $200. You got any?
Oh, come over here. $2 million.
It's $2 million, sir.
Dave, where's your dollar?
Where'd you get those from, Puccini? You look like Madame Butterfly. Just keep writing your lies anyway.
How does it feel to be out after 17 years?
It's beginning to feel great. Hey, Fletcher.
Yo. Take it easy, Dave.
I'm still a celebrity.
Dave, what do you have to say to these kids today?
What? Dave, don't drink. Isn't that the worst drug there is?
Check your own statistics. It kills more than anything.
Hey, come on, Dave.
Give us some room here, please.
Excuse us here, please.
Dave,
excuse us, please.
I didn't plan to do nothing about it.
Dave, what's your husband ready to go about it?
My daughter got nothing to say.
What about Forrest Fire? We're going to be seeing any more of that.
Not for me, you won't.
I got nothing.
Sure. What is your connection?
Excuse me. Wait, whoa. Are you Forrest's daughter?
Why
are you Forrest's daughter?
Will you be seeing him any time in the future?
Oh, God damn, Dave, it's good to have you back.
Welcome home. Thank you. God, it's good to see you out here. It's great to be out. God, it's good to be out. It's so goddamn good to be out. Drive her a little faster, please. I want to lose that place as quick as I can. Whew. When I was going on the merry-go-round yesterday, you have to go around and sign out at all these places. The hacks were all saying to me, hey, Dave, where are you going with the money? You going to the islands, Dave? You going to get an island? Where are you going to spend the $2 million? I told him, don't worry about it. I said, if I got $2 million, I'll let my accountant do it for me.
Dave, I want you to listen to me. That $2 million is a 17-year-old problem that is just not going away. Something has to be done about that.
Charles, you know, and I know, there was never any $2 million. I made Fire for people to have a good time with. I gave it away. I never sold any of it.
Dave, I know that.
Hey, CJ.
Hi, Lee. How you doing?
Have a good one.
Oh, Roscoe. There. Hi, Rosalie. Yeah, did my father get back yet?
He didn't? Oh, well, I'm going to be working tonight at the Egg Cafe, so ask him to come by there, okay?
Is this it? Is this where you live?
Well, it's not much, Dave, but it's home.
Looks a bit lonely to me.
Things to do, people to see.
Oh, Michael.
Hi, Mike.
Howard.
Oh, have you seen Howard's new commercial, darling?
No, afraid not, Howard.
It's okay. We got Channel 5 covered day and night. Tune in, you can't miss it.
Howard was just leaving. You sure you have to get back so soon?
Got to deliver my promises. Business can't run itself.
Oh, I guess you're right.
See you, Barb.
Good seeing you, Howard. What's that?
It's my new commercial. Come on. If we hurry, we can catch it.
Come on, darling. Come on, it's fun.
Come on, listen, I need to...
Shh. It's me.
You called?
Oh, here comes a good part.
Stand back. This is a job for the exterminator.
Those aren't real.
Thank you. You saved my life.
I won't be back.
So, what'd you think?
Yes, Michael, what did you think? That was fine, Howard. Fine. Excuse me. Michael, what's with you?
Mom, I was trying to tell you. I had an accident in the muscle.
What?
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine, but the fender's on the disabled list.
Oh, Michael, why couldn't you be more careful?
Mom, it wasn't my fault. This girl, she plowed right into me.
Women drivers for you.
Her insurance is going to cover it.
Michael, that is not the point. I trusted you with my car.
Piece of junk needs some body work anyway.
That piece of junk happens to be my car, and I happen to be very fond of it. Now, since you decided not to go to college, maybe you should get yourself a real job and buy your own car.
I'll take care of it, all right?
When?
Tonight. It's covered.
Mike, I don't want to butt in,
but... Don't, Howard.
Boy seems under a lot of pressure.
Good luck, Dave.
You're not coming?
No, I'm not coming. This is between you and CJ.
All right.
It's gonna be all right. Now listen, when you're ready, you give me a call, I'll come pick you up.
Yeah, all right.
You look awesome.
Well, thanks. Always here. Jealous of my beauty.
Tie dye.
Look at this. What is this? That's a beer belly, huh?
A little punch.
A little shading in the beard.
Listen, we've got a table for you right here.
All right.
Right here. Sit right down. Saved it just for you.
Look at this.
Yeah.
Where's CJ?
She's in the back. So, what can I get you?
You know what I'd really like?
Name it.
A woman. Max, I've been dreaming for years about one of those big, fat soy burgers.
I remember, Dave. Listen, you're kind of out of luck with that, you know?
What?
Well, I mean, they're out of date. They went the way of love beads and peace marches.
You're kidding me.
No.
Just give me a salad, a nice green salad with no iceberg lettuce, because I still back Caesar Chavez, man.
Right on. Okay.
All right.
Salad, no Caesar salad.
You got it, man.
All right.
Hey, send out CJ, will you?
You got it.
Thanks.
Try anything.
Relax, young lady. My name is McLean, FBI.
Oh, FBI. Well, can I get you anything? A cup of coffee, maybe? How about a search warrant?
I'm here to talk about your father.
Look, my father has paid his debt, so why don't you get off his case?
His case is far from over.
Are you talking about that money that he's supposed to have hidden away somewhere?
It's a concern.
There isn't any money, Mr. McLean.
Some people think there is.
Well, those people are just going to have to deal with the disappointment now, aren't they?
A couple of million dollars worth.
Oh, come on.
We're talking about dangerous people, Miss Forrest. Real dangerous people.
Why don't you earn my taxpayers' dollar then and lock them up?
We can't make our move till they show their face.
Oh, and you want to use my father as bait? No, forget it. My father is a free man now. He's got his whole life ahead of him.
Miss Forrest, you have no idea what's really involved here. But believe this, I am the very best friend you and your father have right now. Trust in that friendship, and you both may live to see Christmas. If you see or hear anything that doesn't sit right with you, you call me, day or night. Please take it.
Max, did you see someone? Just...
Listen, kiddo, there's somebody waiting to see you over at table 10. Go say hello, huh?
Let me just see you.
Yeah.
Look at that beauty.
Hi, Daddy.
God, it's good to see you.
It's good to see you too. Welcome out.
Thank you. I missed you there today.
I was there. You were gone. Dad, don't pull a guilt trip on me.
Okay. It's no biggie. Something wrong?
Some jerk almost trashed my car today, that's all.
What?
Hi, remember me? Jerks are us.
What? What are you doing here?
I came to talk to you about getting my car fixed.
Now? It's not a good time.
No, this is a very good time.
CJ, why don't you introduce me to your dude here?
He's who are you anyway?
Name's Michael. Michael Hawkins.
All right, sit down, Michael. You make me nervous standing up.
Yeah, you should see him drive.
Jump around too much.
This is my father, David Forrest.
Pleased to meet you, Michael.
Dr. Dave.
That's
right. I saw you on TV.
Guilty as charged, time served.
Why don't you two just have a party? I'm going to go work.
Hey,
okay?
Wait a sec. We have something to discuss here, too.
Have some bread.
Feisty.
Oh, yeah. She's been like that all her life. So what's your trip, Michael?
My trip?
Yeah, you know, what are you into? What's your trip? What turns you on?
I play survival games.
You do? Well, don't we all?
No. Survival games. They're games. On weekends we play. Fake wars, fake battles, fake blood, fake guns. It probably doesn't sound too interesting to you, though.
No, that's very interesting. I mean, I just spent 17 years with a bunch of fakes. What do you think? Is survival into us? Or are we into it? Metaphysical, my boy. Don't worry about it.
Well, here you go. Enjoy your dinner. I'll be back to check with you in a little while,
artichoke,
okay?
We said cantaloupe.
Listen, tonight is really a bad night for me, okay? I really don't think we can talk about this.
No, I think this is a very good time for this.
Please, Michael, it's not a good night. I'm trying to work here.
Hey, if you two want to be alone, honey, it's okay with me.
Daddy, we don't want to be alone. We're not together. We don't know each other. We just met. I don't know who this man is.
Don't worry about it. I was young once.
Daddy...
What?
Hey, Max, look, I don't know, I'm just really making a mess out of things tonight, okay? I gotta get out of here.
Sure, kid. Take a break. Go ahead.
So, what's this about an accident?
Well, earlier today, she hit my car.
Dad?
While I was driving home.
Nobody was
hurt. Good, here we go. Let's take care of it now.
Not you.
No, I'm Dad.
I'll talk to you later.
I'm Dad. Enjoy my meal. Where do we begin, CJ? I mean, where do we start?
I don't know. Guess we're supposed to go forward from now and not look back.
Hey, that's Bob Dylan.
You know, Dad, I want you to be happy. I do. I really do.
I'm happy. I'm really happy, CJ. I'm happy to be out. I'm happy to be here with you. I'm just happy.
I've been by myself for a long time now. I don't know how to do this.
Hey, CJ, don't worry about it. It's just that old, mysterious, cosmic root of existence.
I'm trying to have a real conversation with you about you and me, not all this other bullshit that you throw around.
Well, I guess I need a little help with that then. That's for sure, huh? The bullshit?
Yeah, that's for sure. You know, this is really, really hard for me. I mean, you're out, you're here.
What do you want me to do, CJ? Move to another town?
You know, when I grew out of being a little girl, you just didn't want to deal with me anymore.
It wasn't that I didn't want to deal with you, CJ. I didn't have a choice. I was in jail. I couldn't do the things for you I wanted to do. I mean, I missed you, too. I love you very much. And I wanted to be with you.
Dad, I am just really pissed at you. That's all I have to say, okay?
Yeah, well, I'm a little...
Excuse me, sir?
Yeah.
Daddy? Hey, wait a second! That's my fifth...
Shut up! Hey, let her go! Hey!
Thank you.
coming right up our ass.
I'm gonna lose these guys.
Hold on.
Lincoln, I've lost the vehicle. Clark and Gregory Way.
Oh, shit, they're not there.
Let's go back to the restaurant.
Are you sure?
Yeah, we can call the police from there.
This is crazy. I mean, what we did then was, and this is now, and it's, I mean, you can't be serious. This doesn't make any sense. It makes no sense. I mean, you know, we can't do this. We'll never get away with it. What are you doing? Wait, hey, come on. What are you doing? What are you doing?
What happened?
Someone shot Max, the owner. Hey, they were here before. They left in a hell of a hurry.
Let's go.
You guys should call the police?
Let's go now.
Yeah, why don't you?
Excuse me, officer. Yeah. Officer, those two in the car back there, behind you, they were here earlier.
We got the old man, but not the girl.
Well, some punk got in the way, I don't know. And then the cops showed up. Yeah, but we lost him. I think it'd be better if we leaned on him. It'll go much quicker, believe me.
Okay. Hey, baby, okay. Whatever you say.
Why did you pull me away?
We're probably suspects.
What?
Take my word for it, that cop that we lost, he's got a make on my car.
Would you just take me home, please?
I don't think that's such a good idea.
What do you mean?
What I mean is, those kidnappers wanted you, too.
So where should we go?
I know a safe place.
What is it? What's going on, fellas? Damn. This reminds me of my old commune.
This is your old commune, asshole.
It is. It is? It is! Look! Cassandra's painting. Oh, green eyes, that's it! Do I know you? Did we trip together? Who hit me? What for?
There's nothing. Ice. I found something.
What are you looking for?
Whoa. Looks like a combination to a safe.
Yeah, it does.
Oh, is it?
I don't know.
Don't bullshit me, Doc. Where's the safe? Where's the money?
What money?
Don't fuck with me!
Look, I agree, that does look like a combination. But it's not. It's my numerological number. You see, the first set is my name. The second set is my birthday. And the third...
What? Enough with the hippie voodoo crap! Let me work you more. No, cool it, Arnold. We're gonna give the good doctor till 9 tomorrow night to refresh his memory.
You see, Doc? I'm talking to you!
Tomorrow night, when the little hand is on the rhino and the big hand is on the pony, time's up. And Doc, don't waste your time trying to escape. They'll waste you.
Charles, where are you? No thanks.
Well, thank you.
You know, you're dealing with people who play for keeps. Now, I still think you ought to go to the police.
Sugar Bear, we can't. They're probably after us.
Besides, if the kidnappers think we called the police, they might kill my dad.
Do you have any idea where they could have taken him?
I just don't know.
All right, listen. Whenever there's a kidnapping, there's a ransom, right?
Right.
Yeah, I don't have any money.
CJ, you're Dave's daughter. Now, the kidnappers probably think you know where the cash is. So what I suggest, you go back to your apartment tomorrow morning, wait for the kidnappers to contact you, and then take it from there.
I think he's right, CJ.
Okay.
Good night, kids.
Good night, Sugar Bear. Thank you. Oh, God, Charles, I'm so glad you're there. I've been trying to call you all night. Listen, I don't even know how to tell you this. My father's been kidnapped. And, Max is dead.
What? Have you called...
I can't call the police. They might think I killed Max.
What?
And the kidnappers, I don't know if they think I called them. I don't know what they might do to my father.
Yes, yes, I understand. I think we should get together tomorrow and submit a counterproposal.
Charles, what are you talking about?
I can't go into it right now. I'm in a meeting.
You're not alone?
That's right.
Well, who's there with you?
Well, certainly someone I should think with enough authority.
The police?
Something like that, yeah.
The FBI, that guy, what's his name, McLean, he's trying to trace me to you, right?
Well, I believe you're right on that. Now, how can I get in touch with you tomorrow?
Why don't you meet me at my apartment tomorrow morning at, 10 o'clock?
Yeah, 10.
At 10 o'clock.
All right. Well, very good then. I'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Good night.
The FBI. What do they have to do with this?
I don't know. This guy McLean, I think they're after the money, too. You know, he warned me that something like this may happen. God, I'm deep shit.
I think we're in deep shit.
You know, Michael, I'm really sorry I got you into all this.
You haven't heard me complain. Look, why don't you take the couch? I'll take the floor.
How is it, you know, Sugar Bear?
Him and my father served in Nam together.
What about your dad?
He didn't make it.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Ever since then, Sugar Bear's been like a father to me.
Yeah, I know how that is. After my mom died, I would have been all alone if it weren't for Charles.
What does CJ stand for?
It's classified.
Can I borrow a pillow? Good night, CJ.
Baby, you were something else. You remember Monterey? When Otis and Janice and you just blew them away? When you ate your music, man? And when you threw it down there and you peed on it, you lit it afire, you showed the who what. I hope you found peace, brother. Charlie and Max. Boy, have times changed. Look at me. Tripper, whatever happened to you, man? Where are you?
Can't kill your father. If they think he's got that money stashed, well, they gotta take good care of him.
He's always been so special. I never really
tell him that I love him. Oh, boy, he's not here yet. He should be here any minute. He'll be in a limo. He drives a limo, okay?
All right. Hey, everything's gonna be okay. I'll bet you there's a message on your machine right now from your father.
Think so?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, I'll check my messages, okay? I'll be right back.
All right, I'll be here.
Our economics grades a few minutes ago. You aced it, and I hung in there with.
CJ, just wanted you to know you were right. That guy met. Well, once was enough. He can just go to hell.
Yeah, oh, he did. What? Oh, no. No, that's okay. Okay, yeah, thanks. Bye.
Bye.
remember, ladies, with every push-up bra you buy today, a free pair of crotchless panties. And the latest in excuse me for one moment. Security.
Vandalism.
Oh, great. Theft and vandalism.
Yeah, theft and vandalism.
Whoops. Oh, well, don't worry about it, kids. The store's insured.
Let's go.
Just be more careful in the future, huh?
Guy's got radar. Let's go.
Yeah.
Hey, now hold on a second, pal. What do you think this? Hi.
Okay, vandals. We're turning you over to the police.
Finally.
I have to tell you something.
Yeah, what?
When they booked us, I took a peek at your rap sheet.
So? Oh. That, yeah.
CJ. Celestial Jewel.
Yep. Pretty silly, huh?
Should have been Star. It's much simpler. Why didn't they think of that?
I don't know. I really don't know.
I won't be long.
Reckless driving, disturbing the peace, willful destruction of private and public property. Come in. Are you all right?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine. Thanks for coming.
Joe, how the hell are you?
Fine, Mr. Durant, how are you?
Charles, this is my friend Michael, Charles Durant.
Michael, I appreciate what you did. Thank you.
Heard a lot of nice things about you, Mr. Durant.
Listen, I'm sorry I'm so late, but I just got your message, and then I went by your house, and apparently I just missed you there, too.
It's okay.
I heard that Max committed suicide.
You heard what?
Suicide?
Yes.
That's right. The FBI just confirmed the cause of Max Kimmel's death. The angle of entry was consistent with a self-inflicted wound, and his prints were all over the weapon.
Well, what about my father?
Well?
Any ransom demands?
Calls from the alleged kidnappers?
No.
I'm sorry, Miss Forrest, but we can't file a missing persons report until 48 hours have elapsed.
Hey, we saw him get kidnapped.
You may have seen what looked like a kidnapping.
What are you talking about?
Well, it could be this. A man gets out after 17 years in the stir. He's got a couple of million dollars stashed away someplace. He fakes his own kidnapping. The body is never recovered. And he ends up in Mexico tossing down margaritas.
You are out of line.
Hey, we don't have any real evidence to go on. Come on in.
That is ridiculous.
Thank you. Mr. Durant, you want to sign for her, please?
Of course.
You're free to go, young lady. Hawkins, we still got to sign you off yet, sir.
I'll wait for you outside, okay, Michael?
All right.
Come on, CJ, let's go.
Yeah, okay. Wait a second, what about Michael?
We have somebody waiting for us.
Who?
The FBI.
McLean, maybe he knows something. What did he say?
He'll tell us what he knows at Catania's lounge, so let's get out of here.
Yeah, okay, just wait a second. I need to talk to Michael for a minute, okay?
Okay. Don't be too long.
I won't.
Listen, thank you very much for your help.
All right,
I'll see you in the car.
Hey.
At your bike, Mac?
Hey, I'm legal there.
Yeah,
I'm serious, man.
I gotta go take care of something. It's really important.
Where?
I just can't stay right now. I'll call you when I get home, all right?
Sure, you'll be okay?
Yeah, I'll be okay. Thank you. You've really been a lifesaver.
Excuse me, who do I see about this? Somebody want to take my money in here or what?
Probably all out. Having donuts or something.
Oh, back from your coffee break. Good. Where were you when my last three bikes got ripped off, huh?
Out for a red dirt bike just stolen in front of Station 23. Last seen heading east on Grand.
This is Lincoln 94. Your red dirt bike just spotted headed south on Maple in pursuit.
This is Lincoln 22. We've got him west on Elm and we're joining the pursuit.
We'll be right back.
Open the door!
Right, right. Get in there.
What did I tell you, Dave? Didn't I tell you this was gonna happen? Oh, Dave. You never listened to me. You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Jesus Christ.
What's going on here? Do you have any idea how worried I've been?
Mother, would you listen to me? Now, something terrible's happened.
Oh, you're telling me? The police were just here. I mean, what's this about a stolen motorcycle? And where's my car?
Don't worry about your car, all right? Who's this?
Michael, this is Mr. McLean from the FBI.
Oh, good. I'm glad you're here.
Now, will you please tell me what's going on?
Not all night. Your mom is real concerned, Mike.
I'd like to ask you a few questions.
What do you know about C.J. Forrest?
She and Mr. Durant were kidnapped.
Kidnapped?
By the same guys that grabbed Dave.
Who's Dave?
They probably want to use her to get to her father. Make him tell them where the drug money is.
Drug money?
You know, and I'll bet you they're the same guys that killed Max.
Max is dead? Oh, my God. Wait, who the hell is Max?
Friend of that weirdo, Dr. Dave Forrest. He was on the news.
Thanks for your cooperation.
Hey, where are you going?
I'll find your girl and her father. You just sit tight.
Sit tight? Are you kidding me?
Mr. Hawkins, people's lives are at stake here. Let the professionals handle it, okay?
Michael, can we talk? After all, I am your mother.
Somehow, I'll get us out of this. You mean me?
Yeah.
Little hippie magic?
Hey, scuzzbag!
Fiery little bitch. I like him like that.
Just leave her alone.
Whoa! Finally got a rise out of the old doctor.
All right, now knock it off.
Oh, scumbag.
Please.
Please what?
Please, just leave her alone.
Gee, I don't know, Doc.
Harlan here is real attracted to your daughter.
And I hate to frustrate him. Because he gets mean.
Meaner than a stuck pig.
A little trim from your daughter here might be the only way to keep him peaceful. Unless you put your mind to something you know about high finance.
Look, I don't remember anything about any money.
Doc,
don't bullshit me.
Look, I was alone. I don't remember anything.
Doc, put two and two together.
That there was someone else, but...
Who?
I don't know. It was a little person. He was short. I don't remember.
Short?
Tiny.
Don't fuck with me, Doc.
I don't remember.
Better start thinking, Doc. You better start thinking real hard. Your time is running out. There's two.
Now, Michael, let's start with the drugs and work our way up to the kidnapping and murder. Now, honey, Why didn't you tell me you had a drug problem?
Mom, I'm not on drugs. You're confused.
Listen to your mother, kid.
Hey, keep eating, Howard.
Oh, you were always such a good boy. I just don't understand.
Listen, kid, whatever you do, don't get mixed up with this Forrest character.
Hey, what the hell do you know about him anyways?
Plenty. I was a volunteer deputy back when we raided that hippie commune.
Boy, that was something. All us grungy dope addicts living like animals. We used to call it the Free Love Arcade.
Where was this commune?
The old Williams barn up on Route 17. Why?
I gotta go.
Michael, you can't leave yet. The police still want to talk to you about that stolen motorcycle.
I'll explain that later. Howard, I need your car.
Oh, I don't think so. Hey, Mike.
We know you were making it. We know you were selling it. Half the fucking state went cold turkey when you got popped. So what's it gonna be, Doc?
There's no money.
Oh, Jesus Christ! Leave him alone! He doesn't know where the money is.
The fuck he does.
She's telling you the truth. You're wasting your time.
Maybe you're right. Harlan, time to negotiate.
All right, wait a minute. Wait a minute!
Hey!
If you want money, I got money.
Oh, yeah? How much?
I can get you $250,000. Cash. Tomorrow. Just stop this.
Sorry, baby. A quarter of a mil won't cut it.
Hey.
You know, Doc, somehow I get the feeling we're not communicating. Maybe if I show you what I mean.
Don't think!
Don't even think about it. Get rid of that piece of shit.
Down. Down.
Police, we are looking for you today. What I should do is haul your ass downtown and have them book you.
You wouldn't do that.
Don't tempt me, Michael.
Sugar Bear, the police won't listen to me. I know where they're keeping Dave and CJ.
What, that old barn or commune or whatever they call it? That's a pure guess.
No, it's a hunch, okay? Look, let's just go down there and check it out. We've got nothing to lose.
We've got nothing to lose. We're not talking survival camp here, boy. We're talking real ammo, real blood and guts. Now, I say let the authorities handle it.
CJ? 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 CJ Ryder streaking through the sky. So fast, the heavens can't hide her. My, CJ right by. Oh, baby. Do you remember when I used to hold you in my arms? Just sing that to you until you drifted off. God, I love you so much. And I miss you.
Daddy, we can't talk about this now. We're really in trouble. Now try to remember for me, okay? You said you weren't alone that night. You said there was somebody else with you. Somebody short. Who was it?
We were tripping. I mean, there's always somebody with us, but somebody short and dark, I remember.
Was it somebody who lived here, a friend of yours? I mean, come on, Daddy.
CJ, there was somebody short, dark, and hairy.
Oh, Jesus.
Real hairy.
Daddy, it was the 60s. Everybody was hairy.
Not the hairy Krishnas.
Oh,
never gonna remember, are you?
17 years ago. I mean, we all had our stash places, yeah, to keep our stuff and everything. So
wait, stop right there.
I had my own stash place. You're right, that nobody knew about.
Daddy, is it there?
I'll bet it is. It's right over there under my man, Bob.
Shh, don't point where.
See the stove over there?
Yeah.
Right, the left rear leg, right next to it is a brick, and it's there. I'll bet it's there.
The money is there?
Money? CJ, there's no money. I keep telling everybody
what
there's the no money.
What the hell are you talking about then?
Forest fire. My last batch. I bet it's there. Oh, CJ, I bet it is.
Daddy, that's not gonna get us anywhere.
Oh, yeah. It'll get us out of here. I got a great idea. Come here.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Can I get a cup of coffee?
Sure.
Hey. You ever lose at that game? Yeah, I mean, you seem to win all the time.
Hey. I'll take some of that.
My pleasure.
Shouldn't be. Who's the one that taught me to always trust my instincts? And who's been like a father to me for the last 18 years? And who's the one man, no matter what, will always be by my side?
Wait a minute. You can't wrap me around your little finger like you do your mom. Now you quit trying to sweet talk me, boy.
Fine. Sorry. Can I borrow a weapon?
No.
Why are you being so hard?
Trying to keep you from getting yourself killed.
God damn it, Sugar Bear! People's lives are at stake here, and you're gonna sit back and do nothing. Well, thanks a lot. For them, too.
Where do you think you're going?
We thought you could use some more coffee.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you. this stuff is still good. I gave him almost the whole thing. It's not doing anything.
Don't worry about it. When I made that stuff, I made it to last. Besides, the phosphopyridine, LSD, has a half-life of 200 years. He should be crawling the walls any minute now. I was a biochemist. Trust me.
I'll take him out. You take the guy up top. And be careful.
You too.
Doc, come over here. You know, Doc, in 10 minutes I'm a happy man. I'm counting cash, or I'm sliding into something juicy and sweet.
Hey, come on, enough, all right.
10 minutes, Doc. It's your choice.
Cover me.
You got it.
You're dead.
Back
Back up, Dave.
Charles! Back. What are you doing with a gun?
You're behind this whole thing. Even Max. He didn't commit suicide, did he? You killed him.
Oh, no, I didn't. Max couldn't take the pressure. He never could. That's too bad, but that leaves more for me.
Well, what, Charles? There isn't any money.
It's all about money, Dave. You know, back when you were one with the universe, Max, Tripper, and I, we were dealing your fire. We set you up for the bust. We thought we knew where you hid the money. And now, quite simply, Dave, you're going to remember what you did with it, or I'm going to kill you right now.
Jesus! Stop it!
Daddy! Oh my God! Come on, I know the way out. Come on. What's the matter, Doc? Can't take the heat.
This place is not fire. Oh, please,
let us
out of here.
Now, where's the money?
The place is burning up.
No shit, Doc.
Look, we have to get out of here, all of us.
Doc, where's the money now?
There isn't any
Doc,
money!
You got from here to there to find out or think about where's the money.
What is there to think about?
Doc, you stupid ass! Your daughter barbecued, baby. I'm gonna...
You brought it!
You pig!
What are you doing here, little boy? Come to me, Beach Boy.
Watch yourself!
You're not going anywhere.
Look, give it up. If we don't get out of here now, we're all going down.
Nobody is going down.
We're all going up.
No, Michael, I know what's happening. Trust me.
It's all right, hon.
Yeah.
What the hell's going on?
Go with it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Jesus, run!
Okay!
Jump!
No! I guess we can do it!
Michael! Michael!
Jacob Bear! Back here!
You all right?
I don't drink normally.
Dad, you don't do anything normally.
That's right, CJ.
Yeah, but Dave, come on. It's a special occasion.
You're right, Sugar Bear. And what's a few million brain cells, more or less? Allow me, Mrs. Hawkins.
Oh, thank you, Dr. Forrest.
Please call me Dave.
Dave. And it's Barbara.
I'd rather stick with Dave.
Well, Dave, try one of these.
Sure.
Yeah, I think I will, too.
Mm. Michael, your mother is a wonderful cook. What is this?
It's steak tartare.
Bichon meat?
Mm-hmm. Do you like it?
I'm beginning to love it. Barbara, this could be the beginning of a beautiful relationship.
Dave.
Can we eat now?
Yes.
Is that all right?
Yes, dinner's ready. Good. Come on, everybody.
Come on.
You know what? It's really too bad about McLean.
Yeah, well, sometimes the good guys just don't luck out.
Shame of it is. After all that, there wasn't any money.
What I always say is, when all else fails, hug your teddy.
Oh. Well, wait a minute. That's it. The night I was busted, I was with Tripper. Then I was alone. No, there was someone there. There was someone short, dark, and hairy. Short, dark, and fuzzy. When I got busted, I was with Roscoe.
Roscoe? My Roscoe?
That's right.
Who's Roscoe?
My teddy bear.
And when we got busted and Tripper gave me the money, I gave it to Roscoe.
Oh, God.
All right, here we go.
Oh, wait.
Hey, what's wrong?
He's my teddy bear. I had him since I was a baby.
CJ, there's $2 million in this teddy bear.
I know. All right. Waste him. Oh, my God.
Look at all this money!
We're rich!
We're rich! Rich! We'll keep that down there. McLean, I thought you were dead.
Oh, God. What are you doing?
Not McLean. It's Tripper. Don't you remember from the commune? Uncle Tripper? When the Bureau sent me into the commune undercover, I had the perfect setup. I made a bundle. I planted the money on Dave, and I arranged the bust, but the money disappeared. I've been waiting 17 years. I killed Max and Charles, and now all that's left is me and the money. I know it's here.
Where is the money?
I'll let you ride in my motor. them out. With every passing day, you'll see love flying in our hearts without a doubt. Yeah. And if you tell me you can't hear a word, I'll show you what is burning in my house. With every passing day, you'll see dimes and time won't have to be. I'm gonna let you know what it means to fall in love so deep you can't swim out. With every passing day, you'll see love flying in our hearts without a doubt.
Like I said, we will try. Together we will fly. Pick up your head. It's like I said, we will try. Together we will fly. Pick up your head. It's like I said, we will try.